yet another episode of Boarding Pass, your city guide to some of the best cities in the world. I am Parampara and I'm going to take you across your favorite cities in some simple questions. Greetings from Dubrovnik, the city which is known as the Pearl of the Adriatic Ocean. And in 1979, it was named as UNESCO's World Heritage Site. But what really makes it interesting and exciting for most of us is the fact that both Game of Thrones and Star Wars were shot in this very city. And ever since, it has been on most of our bucket lists. So I'm going to take you along across this city in some simple, simple questions that you need to know. Ideally, to explore the city, you don't need more than 2 days. But if you want to experience the city with its excursions and water sports, you need at least 4 days in Dubrovnik while you plan your trip. Dubrovnik experiences coastal climate, which means it's usually hot and humid and never too cold, unlike the rest of Europe. The best time to visit here is from June to September, which happens to be the peak tourist season. If you want to come a little later, you can always come during October, which is less crowded and a lot more fun. Talking money, the Croatian currency is the Croatian kuna. It's accepted all across the country and Dubrovnik is obviously no different. In fact, the Croatians are so strict about using the kuna that they'll immediately send you to one of the many exchange centers in the city of Dubrovnik to get the kuna in turn of the euros or dollars that you're using. There are also a lot of ATM centers in the city. All you need to look out for is for a good exchange rate and the commission that you're being charged on. For that matter, every second shop in this city does exchange and give you kuna. Dubrovnik is a small city, so it's pretty easy to get around this place. You can mostly walk, but all that you need the transport system for is to get to the old town, where most of the attractions are pretty close by. So you can take the bus to the center, which is going to usually cost you 12 kunas if you buy the tickets from a tisap stall, or 15 kunas if you're buying the tickets directly from the bus. Let me tell you, the buses here are really overcrowded, but they're frequent, so that shouldn't really be an issue. You can also take the taxi, but you could be overcharged being a tourist. You can always still opt for an Uber because it's a more reliable option. The other options include renting a boat, renting a scooter or renting a car, especially if you plan to get around the city for day two. Promises to be an eventful trip for you because there's so much to do in this city. To start with, you can go through the old town square and visit the city walls, the cathedral and the other historic sites of the city, which tell you about how the city has survived over the years. Let me remind you, Dubrovnik was named UNESCO's World Heritage Site in 1979. Then you can check out the various water sports and other activities like snorkeling, scuba diving, boating, kayaking, which are available in abundance. You have to try them out over here. All you need to do is check out for the best package that you can get. If you think I'm missing out on the Game of Thrones fans and the Star Wars fans, I am not. I do remember that you have great tours out here to check out the filming locations of your favorite series. And if you still have time, you could definitely go take the one-day trips to Montenegro, which are worth a visit and amazing trip. There are three defining factors of the food in Dubrovnik. The first being, unlike the traditional Croatian or European food, the food in Dubrovnik is mainly seafood, all thanks to its coastal line. In fact, the preference is mainly for smaller fish, for shellfish, clams, oysters, mussels and octopus. In fact, the octopus burgers and salads are very, very popular and sold all across the city. Secondly, the quick eats mainly include bakery products. You'll find a lot of small bakeries all around the city. And finally, thanks to its historic relations with Italy, there's a lot of influence of Italian food here. Every second restaurant would be Italian and you shouldn't really be surprised. So if you love your pizzas and pastas, there's a lot of that in store for you here. Shopping in Dubrovnik became all about souvenirs ever since Dubrovnik became such a popular tourist hub. All thanks to Game of Thrones and Star Wars, both of which were filmed here. More and more fans started swarming in, looking out for their favourite filming locations and obviously taking back a piece of their favourite shows, memorabilia, merchandise and a lot of other cool things available here. For those not smitten by the show, there's a wide range of Croatian jewels, oils, handicrafts and crystals that you can pick from. So shopping in Dubrovnik is something that you're going to enjoy, but what you cannot escape are the tourist traps because this is such a small and touristy city.